Well, I'm a trumpet player, a musician. Me and I've been playing all my life. And I'll be 82 in October. When I was young, I said to my mother, when I grow up, I want to be a jazz musician. And she said, son, you can't do both.
There's an oft-used expression of someone is a gentleman and a scholar. And that starts to describe Al, especially on the gentleman part. But I'm not sure if the whole phrase is correct. I think it should be a gentleman and a trumpeter. To go from being sort of a for-hire musician that plays with everybody, and then to step into the foreground and have his own album and Juno nomination is remarkable.
Yes, I was 79. I mean, I got talked into recording this album by a gentleman who runs a company called Chronograph Records. I thought, yeah, that's what the world needs, is another trumpet album, you know. But anyway, I agreed. And we recorded our first album, which got nominated for a Juno.
And I know all the musicians who played on Al's CD were just thrilled to be there. But I think it's really interesting when people listen to that and say, well, here's somebody who's, you know, over 70 and still creating new works and doing new things. It's really admirable.
What was really fun about it was that I was able to pick the tunes and how we were going to do them, and so that was special for me.
You know, a lot of people think that at 65 is when you retire and life is over. I think for Al just amplifies the fact that no, it's just starting. Al is a wonderful role model for that because of what he's accomplished throughout his career and is still accomplishing to this day.
What I would want younger people to learn from me about Keep On Playing is that it does keep you young.